Hello guys, welcome to Tech Project. Today we are going to make a simple calculator in Java. Take a look what we are going to make. You can see this is a simple calculator which performs all basic operations and work perfectly. It is a very good project for the beginners. For making of this project, you must have installed Window Builder in your Eclipse IDE. If you don't have, then first install it and then continue. Open the Eclipse. Go to File, click on New, then Java Project. Give any name to your project. I give calculator here, and then click on the Finish. Now select calculator, right click on it, go to New, then Other. Here select Application window, which is in Swing Designer. Okay, give any different name. I give Kelsey, and then finish. This is all your source code. Now click on Design. This is the design of your calculator. Resize it according to your choice. Now select Absolute Layout from the layout which help to move and text field and button freely. Now select J text field where all your number getting displayed. Resize your text field according to your choice. Now select J button. Resize it. You can also change the color of the button and font. I set the font bold and size 18. You can set any font. Now change the text on the button to 1. We want 19 more buttons like it. So just first fix the size of the button and then just control copy and paste. Control C copy and then control V paste. And after pasting 5 buttons and complete the one column. Now again resize your calculator, because if you resize it further then it creates some trouble. Now it look fine. Just copy and paste the remaining 15 buttons. I fast forward the video. Resize your calculator according to your button sizes. Now it seems perfect. Now change the text on the button and the name of the buttons. I change the button name to BTN1. Now for second button, I change the name BTN2 and text change to 2. Now for third button, I change the text for 3 and name BTN3 and follow the same step for button 0 to 9. After completing the all button name, now resize your calculator again according to your button sizes. It looks fine now. Now for the turn of button backspace, change the button name by BTN backspace and replace the one by capital letter B. For the symbol of backspace, I could further stay ahead. For button clear, change the button name by btn clear and replace the one by capital letter C. For extra button 00, change the button name btn 00 and replace the text by 00. Now it's time for operators. First we use plus operator, change the button name to btn plus and replace one by sign of plus. For subtraction operator, replace these one by the subtraction sign and also change the button name btn sub. For the multiply operator, change the one by multiply and also change the button name to btn mul. You can give any name according to your choice to any button. Now for divide, replace the one by divide symbol and also change the button name by btn divide. For percentage, change the button name to btn percent and also replace one by the sign of percent. For dot, change the button name to btn dot and replace one by dot. Now for last button, which is equal, change the button name to btn equal and also replace the sign of 1 by 2 equal sign. Now it looks perfect and you can also check it by run and you can see it is work fine. Now it's coding time. For coding, first change the text field font size and set to same as your button font size. After setting, we have to add events to making of this button working. For adding event, just click on the button and double click on the button and we directly go to the code of the button. The code, take a string, give it any name, I give number. Now we have to take a text from the user, so write text field dot get text plus, write the button name btn1 dot get text brackets and then semicolon. Now we have to display this text into text field, so text field dot set text and pass the number. Now you can check it by running if it is working or not. And you can see this working fine. You have to write the same code for the remaining button from 0 to 9 and for dot button. So just copy this code. After copy, go to design, select the new button and double click on it and paste the code and change the button name only. And follow this same procedure for all remaining button from 0 to 9 and 4 dot button. check this whether is it working or not, and you can see it work fine. Now we have to write the code for the backspace, clear and for operators. To design, double click on the clear. On clicking the clear button, we want text field blank. So just write text field dot set text and pass null. After writing, you can check whether it is working or not by running the project. You can see this works fine. Now we have to write the code for the backspace button. Just go to design, double click on the backspace. For using the symbol of the backspace, just replace the B by this numeric and change the font family from Tahima to Wingdings. And you can see the B is changed to the backspace symbol. Now write the code for the backspace button. Declare a string backspace and assign null to it. First check the text field length is greater than 0 or not. If it is greater than 0, then the code is working, otherwise not. After declaring this, now declare a string builder object, give it any name, I give str, which get the text from the text field. Now write the code for the other operators. Before writing, declare some variables. Double, first it take first number from the user. Double, second it take second number from the user, and double result, we store the result of the first and second number. String operation, it hold the which operation to be done, and one more string answer, which hold the final answer. Now write the code for the operators. Go to design, double click on the plus operator and write the code. Assign a number to a first, the first equal double dot parse double text field dot get text, and then write text field dot set text inverted comma and leave it same as it is. Now write down operation equal plus in inverted comma and then semicolon. It take the first number from the user and clear the text field blank. Now write the same code for the all remaining operators and leave the equal, and just change the sign for all operators. The equal operator is left, so write the code for the equal operator. Go to design, double click on the equal and write the code for the all operations. Equal operator check which operation do you want, whether you want plus or minus. So declare a string, give any name. Now we have to write code for getting second number. So second equal double dot parse double text field dot get text. Now we have to check which operation we want. So we have to write if condition for every operator. If operation is equals to plus, then we have to perform plus operation between two numbers and assign the result of these number into result. So result equal first plus second. Now we have to convert these result into float value and assign to answer. So write the %.2f in inverted comma and pass the result. Now we have to display the result on the text field. So just write textfield.setText and pass the answer. The same code for the other operators. Just replace the if by else if and change the operator symbol into the if condition and also into the result. We have 5 operator, so write 5 times this code. After writing this, our project is completed and now the calculator is ready. Now check our calculator by running the project. Click on run and perform any calculation and you can see this work fine and the calculator is ready. Now if you want the desktop icon of this project, then click on file, go to export and go to Java and enable JAL file and then next. Select the desktop from here and you can select or any other thing. Now give your name. You can give any name and select your project from the launch configuration and then click on finish. Now this project is exported to the desktop and you can see this work fine. So thanks for watching this video. Maybe this video helps you. This is my first video on YouTube. So please like my video and subscribe the channel. And if you have any query, then comment down below. I give answer to everyone. And thanks for watching.